You all have been having a lovely rainy day, staying warm and dry. Are we all here for Art 101? All in the right room? Okay, great. I'm Mrs. Williams, but you guys can call me Lily. I'm just gonna jump right into taking attendance. Go ahead and raise your hand for me when you hear your name. If you have any nickname that you prefer to be called by, alright. Do we have a Christina in the room? Hi, Christina. How about Rebecca? Perfect. Becky, you got it. And Andrew. Hi, Andrew. Caleb. Great. Sophia. Greta. Hi, Greta. Lovely name. Angela. Ange. All right. Thank you. Olivia. Hi, Olivia. Michael. Michael. Mike. Okay. Vincent. Right. And last but not least, congratulations, Emily. Since Kyle is missing, we have an open spot just for you. Do you know your student ID number? Okay. 7 4 3 2 0. Perfect. Come see me for a few minutes after class and we can get you officially enrolled, okay? Happy to have you. Now that we've got our group in order, we can actually get started. It's going to be a pretty short, easy day. We'll definitely be getting out early, so before your next class, you'll have a generous chunk of time to grab a coffee, take a nap in the library, whatever you please. Being the first day, our only orders of business are to review the syllabus, which you all should have a copy of on your desk. Is anyone missing a syllabus? I do have extras printed. All set? Okay, good. Go over materials, and if we have time, maybe a quick drawing demo. But I I will judge that based off of your expressions. If we all look kind of hazed and dazed, I won't put you through it. Don't worry. I also will not be subjecting you guys to any icebreakers. I always dreaded first days because of those. I like for this room to feel like a safe haven. No pressure. I'm sure you'll all get to know each other very well over the course of the semester, on your own time, between sharing supplies, asking questions, hopefully offering compliments, but no worries at all. If you prefer to keep to yourself, art, after all, is the ideal introvert's activity. This class is pass or fail, so as long as you turn in all of your assignments, you will do perfectly fine, I assure you. No reason to fret. No. Don't fret. Art is entirely subjective, so it's really not up to me to judge the merits of your work. Rather, just to support you as best I can throughout your process of exploring a variety of new mediums, answering any questions that might come up, and oftentimes, most importantly, offering encouragement. Art can be an incredibly relaxing, rewarding activity, but also quite frustrating when things aren't going exactly according to plan. So it goes a long way to have a helping hand and a friendly face reminding you that it's all in good fun. Do we have any questions so far? Okay, great. Let's begin going over the materials you'll need to purchase. I'm sending you all home with a printed list today. I have them sitting on the desk over by the door, so you can fetch one on your way out. Or if you forget to grab one, I will also be sending out a group email tonight. So I'm going to be exhibiting an example of each and every item so that when you go shopping, you'll know exactly what you're looking for. I know art supplies can be very expensive, so I will always have a bounty of backup supplies here in class. So if you aren't able to get your hands on all of the supplies, or you just forget to bring some on a particular day, you will never be left without the necessary materials. No worries there. Let's start with the most important of all the supplies, our pads of paper. Canvases. First, we have the Strathmore colored pencil pad. This is the 400 series, acid-free, medium surface, white, spiral-bound or sewn is perfectly fine, whichever you prefer. We'll be using these for our daily warm-up exercises. For the first 5 minutes of class, each and every day, you guys will get free time to doodle whatever you like, whether it's an actual figure or even just lines, spirals, squares, anything just to start accessing your creative side and get your hand muscles nice and loosened up. The key is keep it. No pressure, nothing serious. Just have fun. Alright. Any questions about this? Yes, Emily. No, it does not have to be Strathmore. Strathmore is an incredibly popular brand, definitely high quality, mid-price range. You can get cheaper and you can get more expensive, so this is a nice middle of the road, but if you'd like to opt for something cheaper, you're really not going to have any issues, because for our purposes in this class, the colored pencil pad is just going to be for those warm-up exercises, not really any finished professional work. Okay, great. Any other questions? Perfect. We can move on to our next pad of paper, which is going to be acrylic. This one is Canson brand. I picked up all of these at Michael's. You could also opt for Target, a local art supply store, although those do tend to charge a bit higher prices. It is wonderful to support local small businesses, though. So this is cold press, heavyweight textured paper, stays flat, will not buckle. No need for gesso or other preparation. Ready to go right out of the pad. These will be used for media, medium weight. This will be used for the majority of our work due to its versatility. It combines the durable characteristics of watercolor paper with the smooth, workable finish of a drawing sheet, which makes it the ideal surface for is toned tan. Every Friday, we will have a new model come into class to pose for us. It's a very fun exercise, a very efficient way to get a handle on anatomy and proportions. My favorite part, personally, is once everyone is finished, we all wander around the room, admiring one another's work. Seeing how each and every person has their own unique interpretations of the exact same reference. It's a lot of fun for the model to look at, too. The tan shade comes in handy because it offers an overall mid-tone base, so all you have to worry about about the toned tan or the figure drawing. t-shirt that you won't mind getting paint, charcoal, whatever else all over. I have this one here that has a beautiful pomegranate design, screen printed, as well as a as well as a few neutrals. I know I've said this about nearly every assignment I've mentioned thus far, but one of my favorite assignments of the semester is sculpting your own personal imaginary creature. It can be anything you like. Something that already exists, like a mermaid or a griffin, a harpy, also need a set of Sculpey styling and detailing tools. You can just use your fingers. Many people do prefer that. But if you really want to get in there and create the fine details like a beak, the eyes with lots of personality in them, intricate scales, you will be very happy to have a set of metal tools. Shape, smooth, detail, and finish. Dual purpose shaping and smoothing tools with two ends for surface finishing and detailing. For best results, dip tip ends in water before use. Clean with soap and water. This is one of those things that really isn't necessary to purchase on your own. If you'd like to have them all to yourself, go ahead. But if you don't want to spend the extra money, I have a set here in class for all of us to share. Useful tool for mixing colors. On one side, there's this really nifty feature where you can pick a certain color. Let's go with blue. And we can see that by adding red, we will achieve this color. And then by adding yellow, we will achieve this lovely Kelly green. Each and every color on the wheel. so.